हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस। वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट वी स्ट्रगल इन आवर लाइफ इज व्हाट टू डू एंड व्हेन टू डू रिलेटेड टू आवर प्रोफेशंस। नाउ नॉर्मली हाउ डू वी चूज आवर प्रोफेशन और द करियर दैट वी वॉन्ट टू डू? वी इधर चूज इट बिकॉज वी आर वेरी गुड इन स्कूल इन अ सर्टन सब्जेक्ट एंड वी थिंक बिकॉज वी आर वेरी गुड इन दैट सब्जेक्ट if we take it up as something that we get qualified in and then take it up as a profession, then we can do very well. Or we find something that interests us and maybe as a hobby, or we find that we are good at it. For example, when you play sports, we may feel that we played good, we played better than the others, and we have a strong chance at success in sports, for example. So we take up sports. Now, how many times do we find how many people who play, for example, football, make it really big, get famous, make money and do very well in, say, for example, playing football as a career? Or how many people do we know who chose acting as a profession and have done very well, made a name for themselves, made a lot of riches? The percentage of people who choose a certain profession and get very high success in that is very, very less. Maybe 1 in 1,000 people get good career success or even decent career success over a period of time and with stability. This is because we sometimes don't choose the career well, we don't choose the professions very well. So what to do? Sometimes we don't choose it very well. And secondly, we don't choose to do the what in the right time period. And that's why the when becomes critical. We all have heard success stories of somebody who was very good looking, were in their teens, and they were out in a mall or in a cinema theater, and somebody spotted them and asked them, would they like to do modeling? So they said, okay, we can give it a try, it was fun. They took up being a model. While modeling for a few assignments for a couple of years, then somebody looks at them and says, would you like to do acting? The person thinks, okay, no harm, let me try, give it a shot. They do acting. Some of the movies do very, very well and they become a star. So they become a star model, then they become a star actor. And we have many such examples. Sometimes somebody applies to, become a beauty pageant, they win. Then because they win, they also become celebrities. So we have various examples. For example, in India, somebody like an Aishwarya Rai started off as a model. And then from model, they became the Miss World pageant. From there, they got into acting. And then later on, many such examples we have heard that an actor may later on become a director. Some actors have gone on to become media managers. Some of them started their own channels. Some of them have gone on to got into TV software industry. Some of them have gone on to become ambassadors of certain important things in society that they feel is an important cause for them, get associated with NGOs. Some of them become UN ambassadors. Some of them get associated with certain industries, and different times, different periods, they get different successes. Some of us also go through the same alignment where we may start off getting educated or qualified in a certain stream, in a certain subject. We get a certification on that. We may try a hand at that profession, but sometimes we don't get success. Then we try something else and we get some success there. And eventually through trial and error, we land up in some place where then we get success over a period of time with stability, and that takes years. And then before we stumble onto something which gives us more stability and money, and then we feel that, okay, now after many years, I have more stability in life and I earn enough. But why is it that through trial and error we reach the conclusion in life where we should probably reach earlier, and sometimes even through trial and error we don't reach the place? One is because we go too much by semantics associated with worldly success as per our indication, our analytics. And what is that? We look at what we are good at in terms of studies or good at or what interests us outside. Little do we look at into our horoscopes and what energies we are born with and born to do. And many times we stumble onto that by accident. lot of people who are ambidextrous, who can write very well with both the hands, found that out through an accident. Many world champions found out that they can do pole vaulting very well by accident. Many people found that they can do gymnastics very well, again by accident. And some of them go through the laborious process of getting, starting to train as gymnasts since from when they are 3 or 4 years of age, and yet they don't get international stardom or international success even after 15, 16, 20 years of hard labor, and then they go into some other profession. So if we get to know what are the planetary energies in our horoscopes which give us strength in a certain area of what to do, and second, because of the dasha periods which activate certain planets, when to do become critical as well. So many times we may choose, we may be in the same profession that we do, but we may change industries based on what are our planetary energies given to us. For example, somebody who is into marketing may start as marketing for sports goods, and then because of a better opportunity that they get, they may start marketing for electronic goods, and after a few years they may get another break where they start marketing for cars, and few years down the line they may be selling houses, real estate. So different times you may be related to the same profession, marketing, but you may change industries. So what to do in terms of what area or industry that you get related to is also changes. For example, a person that I gave example of starting from modeling, then becoming an actor, then becoming a director, then starting a TV channel, all have one thing in common, and that is the camera. A model stands in front of a camera, an actor is in front of a camera, a director uses a camera to capture his story, his way of thinking, what the story he wants to say, and a TV channel, also the most important component is the camera. So we need to see which area of life we are getting the maximum strength, career or professional strength, what time we are getting the professional strength, and then if we take it up, then we have more chance of higher probability of success rather than through trial and error. I remember a friend of mine who during my college days, I told him that he can be very successful in the restaurant business. And then we lost contact, and after almost 20 years, I met him and asked him what he was doing. He said he is manufacturing industrial goods. And then, you know, he asked me to look at his horoscope, and I said, this time you should be running a restaurant. He said, I did try my hand at running a restaurant, especially immediately after passing out of college, and it didn't work. So I told him that that period of time was not the right period of time for him to start a restaurant business, because he started this restaurant business in the Saturn and the Ketu Dasha, and Saturn has had no association either with his Lagna or with his 10th house, and Saturn is an icy planet. You need other energies for you to get success in a restaurant, especially when related to Mars or with Venus. You need more fiery energy. So he was not successful, and because he was now running Mars Dasha and Venus Dasha, I told him that this is the time for him to get into a restaurant business. And after a lot of thinking, he eventually started a bakery, and his bakery is doing very well now. And a bakery is connected to fire, Mars, and bakery is connected to food, which is denoted by Venus. So if you don't know what to do and when to do, then you will have less or no career success, and you will struggle throughout your life. But what gives you the right career or the right profession and when to do that? Now, your Lagna to an extent gives you that career. The Lagna does not give you the purpose of life. I have already made a video on why the Lagna cannot be associated with the purpose of life, but how you will go about or your approach to life will be through your Lagna. However, the Lagna can play a strong part in your career or profession, which is one part of your life, but it may not be the purpose of your life. And does only the Lagna define what career or profession you will be in? No, but the Lagna plays a strong part, and it is the Lagna and the Lagna Lord energies combined with either the 10th house of career and profession or the second house of earnings and savings, or the fourth house of material benefits and where you will get your riches from, or the 11th house of aspiration fulfillment, that will define which career you need to take up, what profession you will need to take up, and when, because the dasha period of that particular lord has to be activated or active for you to get higher success. You may still get good success in the dasha of a planet which is not active by virtue of placement or by virtue of transits or by virtue of your moon being placed in the nakshatra of that planet. However, higher success comes to you when you do that watch part during the dasha or antardasha of the strong planets whose dasha is gone. The other part is you need benefits to give you benefits in life. So, if Mercury, Venus, Moon, Jupiter get associated with the Lagna, the second house, the fourth house, the tenth house, the ninth house of fate and luck, or the 11th house of aspiration, then you get higher success. And various shlokas have already defined that if the Lagna Lord is strong, then the ascendant gets the strength from the Lagna Lord. And if the ascendant Lord is strong, and if benefits get associated by either being placed in the Lagna or either on the either side of the Lagna or in conjunction aspecting the Lagna, then there is higher chance of success, especially during the dasha period of the Lord, the Lagna Lord, or the benefits who are associated with the Lagna or the second house of earnings. And the more benefits get associated with a house, the more success you get in the areas of that house. So, for example, if you have a Taurus ascendant, and if a lot of planets get associated with get associated with the fourth house, for example, if for a Taurus ascendant native, if Venus and Moon and Jupiter, all three get placed in the fourth house, then you can get tremendous success in real estate, because Moon is the natural ruler of the fourth house, Venus is the Lagna Lord, and Venus is the Karaka of the fourth house, and Jupiter gets exalted in the fourth sign, which is Cancer. So you need to look at what combinations you are getting at what period of time of life, and choose your career and profession accordingly. Many times you may be very strong in a certain career or profession, but there may be a time limit or shelf life to the profession. When the time changes, you may get greater success in another profession or in another industry, even if it's the same profession. For example, a person who is a lawyer may later on become a judge. A person who is a policeman may later on start his own security services. A person who is a sportsman may start his own sports management facility or training facility. So different areas, different industries may get associated or strongly denoted. A person who has a very strong Mars and Jupiter may become a very strong popular sportsman, successful sportsman during the Mars Dasha, and may become a sports instructor or coach during the Jupiter Dasha. So you need to look at what are the strong planetary placements, when they are going to be activated, and then you need to choose your professions accordingly. The more stronger planets get associated with your Lagna and your benefits in the 10th house and the 2nd house of earnings, the 4th house of money and the trine houses, the more career success you will get during that period. So today, let's look at for different ascendants, what energies when they get connected to the ascendant can give you different professions and give you the what and the when part. A shloka says, Yo yo bhava swami drishto yuto ho som yarv syatasya tasyate vriddhi, which means that a sign which also has the support of its lord is very strong. This support can be in the manner of where the lord of the sign is placed and what aspects of other planets are on the house, specifically benefits. Benefits which aspect the sign make it very strong, especially benefits which are friendly to that sign make it stronger. For example, the aspect of Moon on Cancer or Jupiter on Cancer also make the sign very strong. Also,
Benefits which are on either side of a sign also make it strong. For example, Moon and Jupiter on either side of Cancer sign convey strength to the Cancer sign. On the other hand, Venus and Mercury on either side of Taurus sign also convey strength to Taurus sign. Another example is where Venus and Moon are on either side of Taurus sign also make it strong, specifically because Moon gets exalted in Taurus. Thus, each sign is given strength by virtue of how its lord is placed, which aspects are on it, and whether benefits straddle the sign on either side. Now, when you come to the Aries sign, the Aries sign is ruled by Mars. And as we know, Mars is a planet of strength and a go-getting spirit. Mars is also called the general. Thus, Aries are supposed to be people, if they have a strong Mars, then who can be connected to various strength-oriented careers. For example, being in the police, being in the army, or being connected to an activity-based profession such as sports or coaching. And because Aries also denotes the head, thus teaching can also be associated with the Aries sign. So, people who are born with the Aries sign do very well in professions which require a lot of activity, lot of energy, lot of self-enterprise, and lot of exploration and courage. And hence, a lot of soldiers also have a very strong Aries sign or a very strong Mars. The other profession which can be associated with Aries could be real estate, especially if Mars is placed accordingly. For example, for Aries ascendant native, if Mars goes into the 10th house and has the aspect or conjunction of Moon or Jupiter or even Venus, then the person can do very well in careers associated with real estate. This is also because the 4th house for an Aries ascendant is ruled by Cancer, and thus Moon becomes a strong denoter of the 4th house of real estate property, and Venus being the Karaka also is a strong energy giving denoter of real estate, especially when associated with Mars and connected to the 10th house. So when one looks at careers related to a sign, one should also look at where the Lagna Lord is placed and what Karakas are being associated with the Lord and what strength the sign has. If there is a malefic associated with Aries sign with the Lagna, then even when Mars and Moon or Venus are placed in the 10th house, then the success that the person gets out of real estate or other professions related to Mars will be reduced because the sign itself is aspected by a malefic. For example, if Saturn aspects the Lagna from the 11th house with its third aspect, then the person's career will definitely slow down and will take more time to give better gains. However, if Mars and Saturn get associated for an Aries ascendant native, then as Aries rules the head, then the person could do very well in surgery, especially if Mercury also gets associated with Mars or the Lagna, because Mercury rules the sixth sign or sixth house for an Aries ascendant native, and the sixth house is also the house of healing or service related to sickness. On the other hand, for an Aries ascendant native, if Mercury and Jupiter are well placed, are strong, then the person can be a career professional in judiciary or as a lawyer. The person can also do very well as a journalist who uncovers stories which are related to society. A strong Venus can make an Aries ascendant native a good salesman, while a strong Mars and Saturn can also, when associated with the 6th house and the 10th house, can give manufacturing profession, industrial workers, and all those people who work in industries where manufacturing and service of the first order or the second level of workers is associated. As we know, the Taurus sign is a sign of materialism, and Taurus is also the sign which rules the second house, and so such people have a very strong affiliation towards money making, and so can be associated with banking, with financial instruments, with taxation, money lending, and any profession which is related to wealth management, financial management, chartered accountants, and so on. This can be stronger when Mercury, the planet of analysis and calculation, also gets associated with the Lord of Taurus, which is Venus. So if there is a conjunction of Mercury and Venus, or they are in aspect with each other, or strongly placed, or even in a niche bhang with each other, with Mercury and Venus being in the Pisces sign, then too such a person can have a very strong career in financial instruments, banking, and connected to accounts or taxation. However, if there is a conjunction or sharing of energies between Moon and Venus, then such a person can do very well in the performing arts, where the person can be a good musician, can also be somebody with a good voice and can sing well, and also be associated with dancing if Mercury is strong and has the aspect of Moon. The person can also have a career in fine arts if Venus gets associated with or placed in the third house in Cancer for a Taurus native, and if Mercury also gets connected with Venus or shares energies or gets conjuncted with it, then the person can also be a dancer or an artist or a painter. Taurus can also give a good profession connected to marketing and advertising if Mercury aspects it or shares energies with it, especially if Jupiter also gets connected with it. Gemini natives, as we know, are people with strong communication skills and also who can be good writers, can be very creative, especially when Moon gets involved. They can be somebody who can be journalists, they can be writers, they can write blogs, and depending on which house gets connected with Mercury, which sign gets connected with Mercury, or which planet gets connected with Mercury through aspect or conjunction, then Gemini natives can do very well
especially in the realm of communication, marketing, branding, selling or salesman. And if Rahu gets connected with Mercury, then they can also be good science fiction writers, researchers, storytellers. Mercury is also a planet of calculation and analytics. And so, people associated with the Gemini ascendant can also do very well in press or related to journalism. If Mercury and Jupiter share energies, then the person can also write essays, biographies, and give high proficiency in moving media or multimedia also. Mercury getting connected with Venus or Jupiter can give very strong accountants as well. So, a profession should be seen in the order of what planetary energies get connected with each other, share energies with each other, are strong, and how much they get connected to the Lagna or the 10th house, and to an extent the 2nd house or the 11th house. The 2nd house being the house of earning, and if the Lagna Lord and the 10th Lord or strong energy sharing planets such as Venus or Mercury get associated with the 2nd house, either by aspecting it from the 8th house or getting placed in the 2nd house, then the person can also give very strong capabilities, which could be in writing, accounts, finance, research, journalism, language translators, language experts, and so on. The natives are known to be people of high empathy, care for others, having emotions for others, support oriented, and can do very well in the professions connected to service and professions which require high empathy. Hence, Cancer sign ascendant people, when Moon gets connected with Mercury, can be very good doctors or connected to the health industry through either being professionals who are into nursing or who are medical instrument operators, or if Venus gets involved with Moon, then they can be salesmen of medical equipment, marketing goods which are connected to the health industry. Moon, when connected to Jupiter, can also give spas. If it's connected to Mars, then you can have gyms or people running gyms, gymnasiums, or sports people. When Mars, Moon, and Jupiter get connected, or into marketing, when Moon gets connected to Venus, especially when associated with the third house energies. Cancer also indicates professions connected to domestic enterprises such as trade in honey, trade in fruits, trade in vegetables, food industry, and specifically connected to water bodies such as fish. A person with a Cancer ascendant can also be connected to being a marine engineer if sharing energies with Saturn or with Mars, and being connected to the hotel industry if Moon gets connected to Venus. They can be into food industry when they can be
owning or running bakeries, bars, if they also get connected to Rahu, they can also be housekeepers, hotels, superintendents, receptionists, stewardess on the airplane, and they can also be people who can be associated with NGOs, as moon is the very strong sign of caring and support. New ascendant natives are known to have leadership positions in multinational corporations, in large organizations, can also be associated with government or government servants, or in the ministry, in any profession which could be connected to authority and power. And so they can be very good administrators, especially if Sun gets connected to Saturn or with Jupiter or shares energy. Such people of Leo ascendancy, when Sun gets connected to Venus or Venus aspect the Lagna, can also be in jewelry, especially related to gold, or be in bullion trading if connected to Jupiter or Rahu. They can also be as forest officers in leading positions. They can be in constabulary if Mars gets associated with Sun. They can be army generals, commanders, majors, again both with Mars energy as well as with Jupiter energy. They can also do well in hospitals if Mercury gets associated with Sun, and they can be very strong in stock exchange, as Sun is also the natural ruler of the fifth house and can be connected with investments and can also be connected to media, especially with moving media such as movies, either being actors or directors or cameramen, when Venus and Moon share energies with the Sun. Virgo ascendant natives are known to have very strong analytical powers, and these are the people who can be good in any profession which requires strong analysis, requires strong concentration, looking deep into numbers, into data, and can do very well as people who can also be connected to finance, taxation, wealth management, and having an eye for detail. But at the same time, Virgo also being the sixth sign of service, they can also be good librarians, they can be receptionists, they can be teachers, they can be accountants, statisticians, bankers, computer operators, associated with editing reports, anything connected to writing, because Mercury is the Lagna Lord. They can also be into analysis connected to IT. And so Mercury connected to Jupiter can give you a strong profession in IT. Mercury connected with Rahu can also give you strong connections to the professions related to technology, foreign service, postal services, audits, and so on. Virgo natives, when Mercury is connected with Saturn or with Jupiter, can also be in the field of law, as the sixth house is also the house of judiciary and court connections. And so a Virgo native, when Mercury shares energies with Jupiter or Saturn, can also be a lawyer or a judge. Libra is a very strong sign of balance in a person and requires balance based on relationships.
and hence Libra also connects people with professions which could relate to people dealing with others on a day-to-day basis, because Libra is also the seventh house, and the seventh house is the sign of, or the seventh house and the Libra sign is the sign of getting connected to others on a day-to-day basis. So any people who are related to relationship building, for example, spokesperson of big companies, large organizations, public relations officers, media managers, management consultants, can all be successful for Libra ascendants, specifically when connected to or sharing energies with Mercury or Moon or with Jupiter. If Venus gets connected with Saturn or with Jupiter for a Libra ascendant native, then such a person can also be a judge, can also be a counselor, can be a lawyer, can be a management consultant. If Venus is strong and gets connected to Sun, then such a person can also be in the field of arts, singing, acting. If Venus gets connected with Moon and gets associated with the fourth house, then such a person can also be in interior decorators or the interior decorations, home decor, and also into professions connected to beauticians, can be furniture makers, photographers. If Venus shares energies with Rahu, then such a person can also be into designing of cars, designing of jewelry. If Venus gets connected with Mercury, then such a person can be an architect designing houses for the rich and famous. If Rahu and Venus get connected to 8th house, then such a person can also be running casinos and idol shows. Scorpio is a secretive sign, and hence Scorpio ascendant natives get connected to professions related to the 8th house and connected to professions related to secrecy. So such people can be people who could be spies or government officers who dig out data, and all that can be hidden. For example, tax officers, tax consultants, wealth management auditors. They can also be connected to agriculture. If Mars shares energies with Venus for a Scorpio ascendant native, and those food items which are grown underground, for example, all roots, whether radish, carrots, etc. And Scorpio people can also be into theology. They can be missionaries if Mars shares energies with Jupiter. They can be industrial workers in manufacturing, fast moving goods. If Saturn gets involved with Mars, these people could be into jewelry. If Mars gets associated with Sun or with Jupiter and Venus, because Scorpio is also a sign of digging deep, so all those professions such as doctors or surgeons, dentists, deep sea divers, navigators, submarine operators, oil rig people working on oil rigs, if Mars gets connected to Saturn, can have these professions.
Mars connected to Saturn or Rahu can also give connection to morgues or coffin makers or those who are in spy agencies connected to foreign lands. If Mars shares energies with Jupiter and Rahu, Aries is a sign of the bold, the adventurous and the fun loving people, those who respect their privacy and their freedom, and hence Sagittarius natives can be people who can be associated with travel industry, with tourism, long distance travel, ticketing, airline industries, especially if Mars gets connected to or shares energies with Jupiter. Because Sagittarius is the ninth sign, hence high education, university education, PhDs can be a profession which the Sagittarius native can be in if Jupiter gets connected to Mercury or gets connected to Sun. These people can be spiritual gurus or religious reformers. If Jupiter gets connected to Moon or with Mercury, and there can also be teachers or deans of big universities if Sun also gets associated with Jupiter. With Sagittarius natives, if Jupiter gets connected with Saturn or shares energy with Saturn through conjunction or aspect, then they can also be in the banking industry. They can also be in industries related to travel. Car dealers, tour operators, and so on. Capricorn is a sign of the hard-working people and the organized people. Those who like to work under a structure, can work for long hours, they can be completely dedicated to the work on hand, they are less questioning of authority, and are fierce, loyalist, and depending on the connection they make with different planets and the energies, accordingly they can be long, hard-working people who will work long years in the sign which connects them to a certain industry. So Capricorn natives can do very well in the banking industry if Saturn gets connected to Mercury. They can work long hours in call centers and business process organizations if Saturn gets connected to Jupiter or with Rahu. They can be philosophers, and they can also be in theology if Saturn gets connected to Sun or with Jupiter, because Jupiter is also the natural ruler of the ninth house. However, if Saturn gets connected to Rahu, then these people can also be into professions such as forests, into geology. If Saturn gets connected to Mars, then engineering. They can also be into mineralogy, because they have a great capacity for organization and structure. If Saturn gets connected to Sun, then they can be master of ceremonies, hosts of shows. If Saturn, Rahu and Sun get connected, they can also be into media where they organize events and event managers. All those professions which are of service to others, such as the lift operator, the housemaid, the driver, and those who are into home related services such as the electrician, the plumber, the painter, all can be connected to Capricorn sign as well. Aquarius is a sign of thinking big, of finding solutions to large problems. Societal challenges are the realm of the Aquarius native, and hence Aquarius people are the ones who can be connected to NGOs, who raise their arms, raise their hands, raise their voice for society level challenges, whether it is in the neighborhood or get connected to larger problems such as for animal conservation, for weather conservation, and can be connected to NGOs such as PETA or organizations connected to WHO. Because Aquarius is also the natural ruler of the 11th house, so larger society, large organizations is the realm of the Aquarius native. So Aquarius ascendant natives can be also seen in very strong leadership position if Saturn gets connected to Sun or with Jupiter, and can also be connected to the judiciary as Saturn rules Aquarius. If for an Aquarius ascendant native, Saturn gets connected to Jupiter or with Sun, especially when related to the 10th house. These people can also be good doctors, good surgeons. If Saturn gets connected to Mars, they can also be people in unusual professions such as in atomic energy, into research, when Saturn gets connected to Rahu. Such people are the ones who also have come out with breakthrough plans. They start up industries which serve humanity and solve societal challenges. Aquarius natives can also be in psychiatry or psychology when Saturn gets connected to either Jupiter or with Mars, and psychologists if connected to Moon. They can also be in the profession of health if 6th house Mars and Saturn get connected, or if Saturn and Mercury gets connected to the 6th house. Pisces natives are the thinkers, the great imagination professions get connected to Pisces natives, especially if Jupiter is strong, as Pisces is also the 12th sign, and so all people getting connected to imagination oriented industries such as movies, filmmaking, scriptwriting, dancing, choreography can be associated with Pisces ascendants. They can also be good in music if Jupiter shares energies with Venus, and they can be related to travel as Pisces rules the 12th house of long distance travel or foreign travel, because Jupiter 9th lord ruling Sagittarius. So if the 9th house gets connected to Pisces ascendant natives, or the 9th lord gets connected to Pisces ascendant natives, the 9th lord being Mars, then such people can also be into travel, tourism, ticketing, airlines, Jupiter connected to Saturn can give you professions related to oil, as Pisces is a water sign, and to liquids, to paints, and if
nakshatras such as Ashlesha or Jyeshtha get connected, then they can also be people who run pubs or bars or can be associated with the liquor industry. Pisces being a sign of imagination, such people can be leading actors if Jupiter gets or shares energies with Sun, and can be very good writers of science fiction if Jupiter and Moon share energies, either through conjunction or through aspect. Now that we have talked about how the ascendant and the various combinations of the ascendant with the benefics with and other stronger placements by virtue of conjunctions or placements or sharing and what profession they denote and during what period of time, please look into your horoscopes and search and look for what professions or careers will be most suitable for you, during what time they are getting activated, what area or industry that you need to choose in, and where you need to focus your energies on for greater professional and career success. So friends, please like my video, please share my video, please subscribe to my channel. If you are looking for a personal consultation from me, please reach out to me at the links given below in the description box. Until we meet some other time, this is your friend, astrologer and guide Irfan signing off.